Good morning, children. Welcome you all to this session. Today's class, we are going to continue exercise 6.3. You can take page number 102 in your NCERT textbook. In this, we are going to discuss from the fifth problem. Okay? I hope you all have taken page number 102, children, for fifth problem. From the fifth problem, we have to continue. For each of the following numbers, find the smallest whole number by which it should be multiplied so that you get a perfect square number. Okay? Also, find the square root of the number, square number so obtained. See, the same method of problem we have already discussed in our example. Okay? Just what we have to find now? We have to find the smallest number which we have to multiply it with this number to make this number as a square number. Okay, square number means what? We can find the square root from that number, right? Yes, square number means what? It should be a multiple of a same number. For example, 2 2s are 4. 4 is a square number. When I multiply 2 and 2, I am getting 4. Likewise, we have to make this number as square number by multiplying a small number with this number. Okay, so I'll teach you how to do it. First, what we have to do, we should do the prime factorization of this number 252. Okay, just here now in two table, 2 ones are 2. As usual, prime factorization, you can do it. Last class we have discussed, right, the same way you have to do the prime factorization. 2 2s are 4, remainder 1. 6 2s are 12, then 2 table. 6 2s are 12, 3 2s are 6. Then in third table, 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3. Third table, 3 7s are 21, then 7 1s are 7. Now we have found the prime factorization of the number 252. So shall I write the prime factorization now? 252 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7. Whether this 252 is a prime number, sorry, is a perfect number, perfect square number? No. Why? Because there is no pairing takes place here. It is paired. This is paired. But for 7, the pairing is not takes place. So, if you want to make this as a square number, what I should do? I should multiply into 7. So, automatically this number will be a perfect square. Okay. So, in order to make a perfect square, what I should do? In order to make a number perfect square, we should multiply by 7 on both the sides. So I told you already, you should not multiply here alone. You should multiply, if you multiply by into 7, you should do into 7 here also. Okay, see, it is mapped, this is paired, but the 7 alone is not paired. That's why into 7 I'm going to do it here. If I do it in the right side, the same thing I should do it in the left side. So 252 into 7 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7. Now all this pairing takes place, right? Yes. So now this number, what is number? 252 into 7. 7 2s are 14, 7 5s are 35, 36, 7 2s are 14, 17. 1764 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7 is a perfect square. Therefore, 1764 is a perfect square number. Yes, we got the, as per the question, they are asking, find the smallest whole number by which it should be multiplied as to get a perfect square number. So here I am multiplying 7 in order to get a perfect square number, which is 1764. Okay, listen, they are asking one small number which I have to multiply here. So I should get the perfect square number. So as per the instruction, I have multiplied into 7 here and also into 7 here. So I got 1764 as a perfect square number. Also find the square root of the number. Square number. So square root, how you will find? Square root of 1764 is equal to, instead of these two twos, threes and pairing is there, right? So 2 into 3 into 7. Okay, 2 threes are 6, 6 sevens are 42. So answer is square root of 1764 is 42. Therefore, I have found what that number is to multiply on both the sides. Then I found the perfect square number. Then I found the square root of that number. Okay, so three answers you should fulfill here. Okay. Next is number 180. So first, what you should do? You should do the prime factorization as usual. Then we should find what number should be multiplied to get a perfect square number. Then you should find the perfect square number. Then square root. Okay. Then fifth table, 5 threes are 15. Reminder 3. 6 fives are 30. Then in third table, 3 ones are 3. 3 twos are 6. In third table, 4 threes are 12. 2 table, 2 twos are 4. Then 2 ones are 2. So 180 can be written as 5 into 3 into 3 into 2 into 2. Check whether all there is there everything are pairing. Paired, these two are paired, but 5 is not paired. So what number you should multiply to make this as pair? Into 5. So here also you have to make into 5. Okay, in order to make a perfect square number, we should multiply. We need to multiply by 5 on both the sides. This is very, very important. On both the sides, you should multiply. So, what it will happen? 180 into 5 equal to 5. This is this 5, children. Then I'm multiplying into 5, into 3, into 3, into 2, into 2. Whether pairing takes place? Yes. So, now 180 into 5 is what? 0, 8 5s are 40, 900. Therefore, 180 into 5 is 900 equal to 5 into 5 into 3 into 3 into 2 into 2. Therefore, 900 is a perfect square number. Exactly, we got the perfect square number. After finding the perfect square number, what you should do? You should find the square root of that perfect square number. So, square root means 5 into 3 into 2. Only one time you will write when you are writing the square root. 1 5, 1 3 you will write, 1 2 you will write. Correct? 5 3s are 15. 15 2s are 30. So, what is the square root of 900 is? 30. So 30 square is nothing but root of 900. So I have found the prime factorization. In that, one pair alone is missing. So I multiplied that pair on both the sides to make a perfect square number. So I got the perfect square number. After getting the perfect square number, I found the square root value of that perfect square number. Understood? Next, 1008. Okay, next answer. Next is your 1008. So first, what you should do? Prime factorization as usual. 2 table, 2 5s are 10, 0, then 4 2s are 8, then again 2 table, 2 2s are 4, reminder 1, 5 2s are 10, 2 2s are 4, then 2 table, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, reminder 1, 2 6 are 12, then 2 table, 2 6 are 12, 2 3s are 6. Then third table, 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3. Then in third table, 3 sevens are 21. Then seventh table, 7 ones are 7. Okay, now 1008 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7. Okay, now check whether pairing takes place. Paired. But for 7, the pairing is missing. Okay? If the pairing is missing, what we should do? We should multiply that 7 on both the sides. Because here 7, the number pair for 7 is missing. So, I have to multiply 7 on both the sides. So, you can write the statement. In order to make a perfect square, okay, perfect square number, what you should do? We should multiply by 7 on both the sides. For this question, 7, okay, because here 7 pair is missing, so I'm going to multiply 7 on both the sides. So, I'm going to write it in the next page. 1008 into 7 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7. Okay. So, actually see this. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7 is there. If I multiply 7 on both the sides, one more 7 will come here. So, automatically, here the pairing is takes place. Okay, pairing is going to take place. So, what it will become? 1008 into 7 is what, children? 8 sevens are 56, 5, 0, 7. So, 7056 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7. Now, is this a perfect square? Yes, of course, it is a perfect square. Why? All the pairing takes place. Therefore, 7056 is a perfect square number. Okay, it is a perfect square number. Just keep this in your mind. Okay, now what we should find now? Square root of that perfect square number. So, what I'm doing? Square root of 7056. So, 2 into 2 into 3 into 7. 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 7s are 7 2s are 14, 1 84. Answer is 84. So, what is the square root of 7056? 84. Okay. 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 7s are 84 is your answer. So, square root of 7056 is 84. So, that is your square root value. Next, fourth problem, 2028. So, what is the next problem? 2028. So, first what you should do? You should take the prime factorization as usual. 2 ones are 2, 0. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. Into table, 2 fives are 10, 0. Because 1 cannot divide it by 2. So, I'm taking 14. So, listen, this 1 cannot be divisible by 2. So, what I'm taking 14 as together. So, I have to include one 0. 7 twos are 14. Then, 5, 0, 7. Whether it comes in 2 table? No. Third table? Yes, 3 ones are 3, reminder 2, 6 threes are 18, reminder 2, 9 threes are 27. Next, 169 comes in third table, no, fifth table, no, seventh table, no, 11, no, 13, yes, 13 ones are 13, reminder 3, 13 threes are 39. Okay, so 13 ones are 13. So 13s are 169. 13 ones are 13. So how we will write? 2028 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 13 into 13. Whether any pairing takes place here? Yes, these two are paired, but 3 is not paired. Okay, so we have to multiply by 3 on both the sides, right? So in order to in order to get a perfect square number. Perfect square number, we should multiply. We should multiply by 3 on both the sides. Okay, I'm just multiplying by 3 on both sides because this 3 is, for this 3 there is no pair, so I'm going to make it as pair. 2028 into 3 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 13 into 13. Okay, so now everything is paired, right? Yes. Now what you should find, children? 2028 into 3, right? 8 threes are 24, 2 threes are 6, 7, 8, 0, 3 twos are 6. So answer is 6084 is equal to 2 into 2, 3 into 3 into 13 into 13. Okay, now everything is paired. Therefore, 6084 is a perfect square number. Okay, now we have found the perfect square number. Yes, now what we should find? Square root of that but perfect square number. Square root means what? You will write only one time. For this 2, only 1, 2 will be written. For this 3, only 1, 3 will be written into 13. Okay, 3 2s are 6 into 13. So 13 into 6 is what? 6 3s are 18, 1 7. 78 is the square root of 6084. So this is what your square root of 6084. So just check whether we have done a prime factorization. We have multiplied one small number, then I've made one perfect square number, then square root of the number. So four steps are taking place here. So be careful while you're doing this. So whether four steps are there, then you go to the then you will check whether your answer is correct or not. Okay. 1458. So first do the prime factorization. 1458 into table. 2 7s are 14, 2 2s are 4, remainder 1. 8 has become 18, 9 2s are 18. Then 729, it comes in third table. 3 2s are 6, remainder 1. 4 3s are 12, 3 3s are 9. Then again in third table, 8 3s are 24. 3 1s are 3. Then again in third table, 3 2s are 6. Reminder 2. 7 3s are 21. Then third table, 9 3s are 27. 3 3s are 9. Then 3 1s are 3. Okay. Now, 1458 is equal to 2 into 3. In how many 3s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now pairing takes place or not? For 2 alone, there is no pairing. So what you should do? In order to get a perfect square number, what you should do, children? We should multiply by 2 on both the sides. Okay, actually in order to get a perfect square number, what I should do? I should multiply by 2 on both the sides. So 1458 into 2 equal to 2 into 2, because this is this 2 and I'm multiplying by 2, that this 2 is this one. 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, now 1458 into 2 is what? 8 2s are 16, 5 2s are 10, 11, 4 2s are 8, 9, 2. So 2916 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, in this whether everything is paired, check once, okay? Once or twice you can check it. So only then you won't make mistakes. Therefore, 2960 is a perfect square number. Now, what we have to find next? We should find the square root of 2916. So, what you will do? 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. 3, 3, 3. Now, 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27. 27 into 2, 7 2s are 14, 2 2s are 4, 5. So 54 is the square root of 2916. 54 is the square root value. Understood? Next is your sixth problem. Okay, what is the sixth problem, children? 768. Sixth problem is 768. So first you do this prime factorization as usual. 2 table, 2 3s are 6, 1. 8 2s are 16, 2 4s are 8. 2 table, 2 1s are 3, 9. 9 2s are 18, 2 2s are 4. Then 2 table, 9 2s are 18, remainder 1, 6. Then 3rd table, 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6. Then 2 table, 2 1s are 2, 16. Okay, 2 table, 8 2s are 16, 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. Okay, so now what can be written? 768 can be written as 2 into 2. How many 2s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. First you write all the 2s, children. Then you write the 3. Here this is given, right? First you write all the 2s. 8 2s are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 into 3. Here everything is paired. No, 3 don't have a pair. So what you should multiply now? In order to get a perfect square, you should write, you should multiply by 3 on both the sides. Okay. In order to get a perfect square number, we should multiply by 3 on both the sides. Keep it in your mind, 3 on both the sides. So 768 into 3 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Okay, now everything is paired. Yes, so we should find 768 into 3. Okay, 8 3s are 24, 6 3s are 18, 19 20, 7 3s are 21 23. So 2304 is equal to 2 into 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 3 into 3. Okay, so in this, now everything is paired, right? So obviously 2304 is a perfect square number. Yes, of course it is a perfect square number. Next, square root of 3004 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 3s are, 6 3s are 18, 1 4 48. So what is the square root of 2304, children? 48. Square root value is 48. 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 2's are 16, 16 3's are 48 is your answer. Okay, did you understand? Just find the prime factorization, check whether the pairing is takes place. If there is no pairing, which number is not paired, you multiply that number on both the sides and make that number a perfect square number, then find the square root of that number. Understood? Today's class we have discussed fifth problem from exercise 6.3. It is actually, we have to find the prime factorization and we have to make the number a perfect square, then we should find that number a square root. Okay, I hope you all understood, children. Thank you.